Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
In this video, we are going to explain the uniform circular motion, write the time equation of the uniform circular motion, calculate the period of the uniform circular motion, and solve an exercise about uniform circular motion.
Observe this animation. The motion of each ball is uniform circular. In the next slides, we will explain the uniform circular motion. In this animation, the ball moves on a circular path. And since the ball has a constant speed, then the motion of the ball is said to be uniform circular motion. We know that the tangential acceleration is the time derivative of the speed. So in uniform circular motion, the tangential acceleration equals zero. And the angular acceleration is given by at over r. Since at equals zero, so the angular acceleration of a uniform circular motion equals zero. Now let's study the normal acceleration. We know that the normal acceleration is given by the speed squared over the radius of the circle. R is constant, V is constant, so the normal acceleration is constant. So we can conclude that in uniform circular motion, the speed is constant, the tangential and the angular accelerations are equal zero, and the normal acceleration is constant.
Consider a particle M moving on a circular path. We want to determine the time equation and the period of its motion. You know that theta prime equals V over R, but the speed is constant because the motion is uniform. Then theta prime is constant. Therefore, theta equals theta prime t plus theta zero. But what is theta zero? Theta zero is the initial angular abscissa. It is the angular abscissa of particle M when we start timing. Let's move to the period. The period is the time needed by this particle to complete one cycle or to cover one complete circular path. Now, generally, to calculate the speed when it is constant, we just divide the distance by the time. When the particle completes one cycle, it covers a distance which is equal to the circumference of the circle during a time which is equal to the period. Rearrange. T equals 2 pi r over v. Now, theta prime equals v over r. Then r over v equals 1 over theta prime. Then we can calculate the period also by using this expression. 2 pi over theta prime.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's solve an application. A particle P moves along a circular path of radius r equals 0.5 meter. The angular abscissa of P is given by 3t plus pi over 2 in SI units. Number 1. Specify the nature and the direction of the motion of P. To specify the nature of the motion, we have to calculate the value of theta prime. And to specify the direction of the motion, we have to specify the sine of theta prime. Now let's calculate the value of theta prime. Theta prime is the first derivative of theta. Theta equals 3t plus pi over 2. The time derivative of 3t equals 3. And the time derivative of pi over 2 equals 0 since pi over 2 is constant. Now theta prime is constant, so the nature of the motion is uniform. Theta prime is positive, so P moves in the chosen positive sense, which is the counterclockwise as shown on the figure.
Let's move to part 2. Where does we start timing the motion of P? We start timing at time 0, then replace T by 0 in the expression of theta. This is going to be theta 0 equals 3 times 0 plus pi over 2, which is equal to pi over 2 radians. Look at the circular path. This is pi over 2. And then the particle is at point B when we start timing. Let's move to part 3. Deduce the angular displacement of P between time 0 and time t. The angular displacement equals delta theta, which is equal to the final theta minus the initial theta. Final theta is at time t, which is equal to 3t plus pi over 2. And initial theta is pi over 2 radians. Then replace theta by 3t plus pi over 2 and theta 0 by pi over 2. Therefore, delta theta equals 3t, and it is expressed in SI units.
Number 4. Calculate the instant at which the angular displacement becomes 12 radians. We proved in the previous slide that the angular displacement delta theta equals 3t. So, delta theta equals 12 radians at time 4 seconds. Number 5. Calculate the time needed by P to complete 3 cycles. Since the motion of P is uniform circular, so the period of P is given by 2 pi over theta prime. But theta prime equals 3 proved before. So the period is 2.1 seconds. So the time needed by P to complete 3 cycles is equal to 3 times t. So the total time needed by P to complete 3 cycles is 6.3 seconds.
Let's move to part 5. Determine the magnitude of the acceleration vector. To calculate the magnitude of the acceleration vector, we need to calculate the values of the tangential and the normal acceleration vectors. Let's start with the tangential acceleration. The value of the tangential acceleration is the time derivative of the speed, but this is a uniform motion, then the speed is constant. Therefore, the magnitude of the tangential acceleration vector is 0. Before calculating the magnitude of the normal acceleration vector, let's calculate the speed of this motion. V equals r theta prime. Replace r by 0.5 meters and theta prime by 3 radians per second. Therefore, the speed is 1.5 meters per second. The magnitude of the normal acceleration vector is given by V squared over r. V equals 1.5 meters per second and r equals 0.5 meters. Therefore, the magnitude of the normal acceleration vector is 4.5 meters per second squared. Now, the acceleration vector is the sum of the tangential and the normal acceleration vectors, but at equals 0. Therefore, a equals an. Then the magnitude of the acceleration vector is 4.5 meters per second squared.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.